Dear students, today we will discuss chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Yesterday continuous video. Okay, here we discuss first we will discuss the reduction. Yesterday we discussed nucleophilic addition reaction and condensation with ammonia and derivatives of ammonia. Today we will discuss first we will discuss the reduction. Reduction. Aldehydes and ketones easily undergoes reduction in the presence of various reagents. Okay, for example, in the presence of metal, hydrogen, or sodium borohydride, lithium aluminium hydride. In the presence of these reagents, aldehydes, that means R C double bond O H. Aldehydes, just here add hydrogen. Here in presence of any metal, hydrogen, sodium borohydride, lithium aluminium hydride, any reagent, aldehydes converts into primary alcohols. Aldehydes converts into primary alcohols. That means two nascent hydrogens are there. Here one hydrogen added it one carbon, carbonyl carbon, and other oxygen, and form the primary alcohols. If you take ketone, add two nascent hydrogens. One hydrogen added here, another here, that means one hydrogenate carbon, another hydrogenate oxygen, in the presence of same reagent, metal hydrogen means tin hydrogen, zinc hydrogen or any, palladium hydrogen, platinum hydrogen or any, and forms R CH OH R. This is called as secondary alcohols. Here we'll get the primary alcohols by the reduction of aldehydes. Secondary alcohol by the reduction of ketones. And here, you see the one difference between sodium borohydride and lithium aluminium hydride. Sodium borohydride is mild reducing agent. Lithium aluminium hydride was strong reducing agent. What is the difference between these two? Here I am taking one simple example. CH3, CH, double bond, CH. Here C double bond O H. This is crotonaldehyde. Here this undergoes reduction in the presence of two reagents. One is sodium borohydride and other one is lithium aluminium hydride. In the presence of sodium borohydride means it is a mild. This aldehyde functional group undergoes reduction. Aldehyde functional group undergoes reduction and form the concerned primary alcohols. This double bond does not undergoes reduction. That means we'll get here CH3, CH, double bond, CH. Here CH2, OH. What is the name of this molecule? 2-butenol. We'll get the 2-butenol. In presence of lithium aluminium hydride, double bond undergoes reduction and C double bond OH, that means aldehyde functional group also undergoes reduction. That means lithium aluminium hydride is strong reducing agent. What happened here? It also CH double bond CH group becomes CH2. Here also one hydrogen added. Here also one hydrogen added. And forms CH2OH. We'll get the butanol. Here we'll get the unsaturated alcohols. Here we'll get the saturated alcohols. In the presence of sodium borohydride, we'll get the unsaturated alcohols. And here in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride, we'll get the saturated alcohol. In presence of these, we'll get the primary and secondary alcohols. This is about the just one reduction in the presence of reduction of aldehydes and ketones in the presence of metal hydrogen and mild reducing agent sodium borohydride, strong reducing agent lithium aluminium hydride. Okay, in continuation we'll see the reduction in the presence of specific reagents. Okay, here in presence of these specific reagents, specific reagents means here I am taking R, C double bond O, H. Add two hydrogen. In the presence of zinc mercury hydrochloric acid, here I am taking R dash. R dash is equal to hydrogen means aldehyde. R dash is equal to R means ketone. R means alkyl group. In the presence of zinc mercury hydrochloric acid, this C double bond O function group becomes CH2. Here C double bond O functional group becomes CH2. That means R CH2 R dash will get the alkanes. This we called as this reduction. What is that? Aldehydes or ketones undergoes reduction in the presence of zinc mercury hydrochloric acid. Zinc amalgam, mercury compounds we called as metal mercury compounds are we called as amalgams. Zinc amalgam hydrochloric acid form the alkanes. Here this is the one type of reduction, and one more reduction is there, R dash. Here R dash is equal to H aldehyde. R dash is equal to R, be called as ketone. It also undergoes reduction in the presence of hydrazine. It forms R C double bond N NH2 R dash. In presence of potassium hydroxide, and ethylene glycol. Here I am taking ethylene glycol. In presence of ethylene glycol, this undergoes reduction. This bond undergoes reduction. Here hydrogen added. Here also hydrogen added, and we'll get RCH2 R dash. This reduction, first reduction in the presence of hydrazine and potassium hydroxide and ethylene glycol, we called as Wolff-Kirchner reduction. This reduction we called as the conversion of carbonyl compound aldehyde or ketones into alkane in the presence of hydrazine, potassium hydroxide and ethylene glycol, we called as Wolff-Kirchner reduction. The conversion of aldehydes and ketones into alkanes in the presence of zinc mercury hydrochloric acid, we called as Clemmensen reduction. This we called as Clemmensen reduction. That means these are the two important reductions, Clemmensen reduction and Wolff-Kirchner reduction. What is the Clemmensen reduction? Aldehydes or ketone converts into alkane in the presence of zinc mercury hydrochloric acid. What is the Wolff-Kirchner reduction? Aldehydes or ketones are converting into, alkanes in the presence of hydrazine, potassium hydroxide and ethylene glycol. We called as Wolff-Kirchner reduction. This is about the reduction. Then in continuation we'll see the oxidation. Oxidation of carbonyl compound gives carboxylic acids. Here the oxidation of aldehydes in the presence of any oxidizing agent, potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate, potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate, chromium trioxide. Okay, mild oxidizing agents also can be used here. Fehling's reagent, Tollens reagent, and here sodium hypohalite. Okay, that means iodoform reaction. That is iodoform reaction. Okay, in the presence of strong reduced oxidizing agents and mild oxidizing agent, aldehydes and ketones were converting into carboxylic acid, concerned carboxylic acid. Okay, here first we'll see the oxidation of aldehyde in the presence of KMnO4, K2, Cr2, O7, chromium trioxide, PCC, pyridinium chlorochromate. Okay, this converts into carboxylic acid. Here, I wanted to explain one important thing. Okay, the reactant side, 2 carbon atoms are present. The product side also, 2 carbon atoms are present. So that means, when aldehydes undergoes oxidation, we'll get same number of carbon containing carboxylic acid. Reactants and products are having same number of carbon atoms. Okay, for example, you take ketone, R dash, RR dash. Okay, here oxidation, it undergoes oxidation in the presence of any reagent. Here also we'll get the carboxylic acid along with the carbon dioxide. Okay, here we have 3 carbon atoms, but here we have the 2 carbon atoms. That means less number of carbon atoms are present. Okay, the oxidation of the ketones gives the carboxylic acid with the less number of carbon atoms, than reactants. Here I am taking R C double bond O CH2 R dash. Okay, this is the one molecule. Okay, here oxidation of this one, what you will get here? R C double bond O OH plus R CH2 COOH. Okay, here 2 carbon atoms, here 3 carbon atoms, but here 4 carbon atoms are present. Here 2 carbon atoms, here 3 carbon atoms. That means we get the less carbon atoms containing molecules, less carbon atom containing carboxylic acid. We'll get the less carbon containing carboxylic acid. For example, you take acetaldehyde, oxidation of acetaldehyde, but during presence of same reagent, we'll get the acetic acid. Okay, acetic acid, how we'll get the acetic acid? Okay, oxidation means addition of oxygen. CHO is there, you add the oxygen here, we'll get the COOH. Addition of oxygen we called as a oxidation. Okay, if you take acetone or butanone, here I am taking butanone. Okay, butanone, oxidation of butanone, we'll get the, these two parts. Okay, here we'll get two types of compounds. One, if this bond will break, CH3COOH plus this part also undergoes oxidation, CH3CH2COOH. Or if this part undergoes broken, what happen? We'll get CH3COOH plus here CH2CH3CH2CH2COOH. We'll get this molecule. Okay, here we'll get the different molecules, by the oxidation of, aldehydes and ketones. These are the, this is about the oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, in presence of potassium permanganate, and, potassium dichromate. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the, aldehydes and ketones also undergoes oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents like Tollens reagent and Fehling's reagent. What is the Tollens reagent? What is the Tollens test? What is the use of Tollens test? What is the Tollens reagent? Okay. Here, in the presence of Tollens reagent, aldehydes are converting into carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. That is the reaction. What is the Tollens reagent? silver nitrate. Okay, ammonical silver nitrate solution we called as Tollens reagent. Ammonical silver nitrate solution we called as Tollens reagent. It is prepared by the reaction between silver nitrate, sodium hydroxide and ammonia. First, silver nitrate add into the sodium hydroxide, form the silver hydroxide, okay, ash color precipitate. This ash color precipitate dissolved in ammonia and form the ammonical silver nitrate solution. Ammonical silver nitrate solution. This ammonical silver nitrate solution we called as Tollens reagent. Ammonical silver nitrate solution we called as Tollens reagent. Okay, when aldehyde, okay, reacts with the ammonical silver nitrate solution. Ammonical silver nitrate solution. Okay, here due to the presence of this hydrogen, okay, here silver ion, is there in the presence of base. Silver ion, it provides silver ion. This silver ion gains the one electron from hydrogen, and converting into silver mirror precipitate, this OH minus ion added here and form the carboxylic acids. Okay, this is silver mirror precipitate. What is the meaning of silver mirror precipitate? The precipitate which is formed on the test tube walls. Okay, the precipitate which is formed on the test tube walls we called as mirror precipitate. Here silver formed on test tube walls, so we called as silver mirror precipitate. Okay, here see, in presence of this ammonical silver nitrate solution, that means Tollens reagent, it is a mild oxidizing agent. Aldehydes are converting into carboxylic acid. Here silver undergoes reduction. Silver undergoes reduction by the gaining of one electron from hydrogen. Okay, and form the silver mirror precipitate. So aldehydes acts as good reducing agents. Okay, here Tollens reagent is mild oxidizing agent. So this can't oxidize the ketones. Okay, that means ketones are not oxidized in the presence of Tollens test. That means this test is used for the distinguish aldehydes from the ketones. Aldehydes give the positive test with silver ammonical silver nitrate solution, but not the ketones. Okay, this test is used for the distinguish of aldehydes from the ketones. Then we'll see the Fehling's test. Okay, Fehling test means here we have the two Fehling solution. Fehling solution A, Fehling solution B. By mixing of these two, we called as a Fehling's reagent. Okay, Fehling solution means aqueous copper sulfate solution we called as Fehling's A solution. What is the Fehling's A solution? Aqueous copper sulfate solution we called as a Fehling's solution. Okay, here sodium potassium tartrate we called as Fehling's B solution. This is also called as Rocelli salt. Sodium potassium tartrate we called as Fehling B solution. This is also called as Rocelli salt. This we called as Fehling B solution. Fehling A and Fehling B solution, both are we called as Fehling A solution. When aldehyde or ketone does not give this test, only aldehyde give only this test. Okay, here copper sulfate means Cu plus 2 ions. Okay, in the presence of OH minus ion, Rochelle is argues. Okay, here in the presence of base. Okay, this in the presence of base. Okay, here it releases hydrogen. It releases hydrogen means RC double bond O plus we form okay OH, and here this hydrogen donate the electron towards the copper and it becomes Cu2O. Cu2O, that means cuprous oxide. Cuprous oxide red color precipitate. Cuprous oxide red color precipitate was formed. Okay, due to the formation of this red color precipitate, okay, we have to identify the aldehydes. We have to distinguish the aldehydes from the ketone. Ketone does not give this test due to the mild nature of failing A solution and failing B solution, failing reagent. Okay, here red color here we will get the red color precipitate. So in the presence of aldehydes, okay, here in the presence of aldehydes, Cu plus 2 ions are okay converting into Cu plus 1 ions, that means they are reduced. That here aldehydes acts as a good reducing agent. Okay, glucose and fructose. Glucose gives positive test with that ammonical silver nitrate and failing solution. That's why glucose we called as a reducing sugar, but not the fructose. Fructose has keto functional group, glucose has aldehyde functional group. Okay, this is about the tolerance test and failing test. Okay, and in continuation we'll see the one more important test. Okay, iodoform test. Iodoform test. CHI3 haloform or iodoform. Okay, CHI3 we called as iodoform. It is a yellow color precipitate. Okay, iodoform test is used for the okay, sometimes we called as iodoform test, but in when we do the practicals, when we do the practicals, we use only iodine. That's why we called, most of the times we called as iodoform test. Okay, here this test is used for identification of methyl keto functional group, which have methyl keto CH3 C double bond O functional group. Those only give the positive test with the okay positive iodoform test or haloform test. Here also aldehydes are ketones converting into concerned carboxylic acid. Okay, concerned carboxylic acid. Okay, here I am taking one aldehyde. Aldehyde or ketone, that means which have CH3 C double bond O functional group. Okay, which not have CH3 C double bond O functional group, those not gives the haloform test. Okay, here it is addition with 3 moles of iodine in the presence of base. In the presence of strong base, what happened? This becomes, okay, here CH3, okay, this becomes formic acid. It forms formic acid. This CH3 group gives CHI3 iodoform. Here also same. 2 carbon containing aldehyde converting into 1 carbon containing carboxylic acid. Suppose for example CH3 C double bond O CH2 CH3. Okay, butanone is there. This also has methyl keto functional group. This reacts with okay 3 moles of iodine and sodium hydroxide. Okay, 3 moles of iodine and sodium hydroxide will give the sodium iodide. Okay, sodium hypoiodide. Okay, here same reaction, here will get the okay this part undergoes oxidation and form CH3, CH2, COOH and will get the CHI3 iodoform. Here we have 4 carbon atoms, but here we have 3 carbon atoms. Here we'll get the less number carbon atom containing carboxylic acid than okay reactants. This test, aliform test, chloroform test, it is used for the identification of methyl keto functional group. Okay, suppose for example, formaldehyde is there and esterdehyde is there. Okay, how do you identify, how do you distinguish the acetaldehyde from formaldehyde? Okay, acetaldehyde gives the positive aeriform test, but not the formaldehyde. So suppose for example, how do you identify the aldehyde from ketone? How do you identify the acetone from the acetaldehyde? Acetone is the aldehyde, acetone is the ketone. Okay, acetaldehyde gives positive tolerance test, positive failing test. Okay, here it does not give positive tolerance test, okay, positive failing test. That means negative tolerance test, negative failing test. Okay, acetaldehyde gives positive tolerance test and positive failing test, but not the acetone. So, acetaldehyde distinguished from the acetone by using these two tests, failing test and tolerance test. Formaldehyde and acetaldehyde, okay, distinguish, okay, by the this haloform test. These are the important tests used for the distinguishing of aldehydes and ketones. Carbonyl compounds are distinguished from the other molecules by using 2,4-DNP test. Yesterday we saw that test, okay, that reaction also we did. Okay, next in continuation we'll see the some important reactions, Cannizzaro reaction. And here in continuation we have two reactions, one is Cannizzaro reaction, one is aldol condensation or ketol condensation, and cross aldol cross ketol condensation reactions are there. Okay, here, okay, I will discuss last reaction today, Cannizzaro reaction, which are not having the alpha hydrogen. The aldehydes are ketones, the aldehydes, exclusively aldehydes. Okay, the aldehydes which are not having the alpha hydrogens, those only involves in Cannizzaro reaction in the presence of strong base. The aldehydes and ketones are undergoes, the aldehydes, the aldehydes undergoes, okay, condensation reaction in the absence of alpha hydrogens. That means formaldehyde and benzaldehyde not having the alpha hydrogens. So those are easily involved in the oxidation and reduction, that means disproportionation reaction, and form the alcohol and concerned salts of carboxylic acid. Here I am taking 2 moles of formaldehyde. Okay, this is 1 mole. Here I am taking 1 more mole of formaldehyde. Okay, here these two aldehydes are not having the alpha hydrogen. What is the meaning of alpha hydrogen? Okay, here for example, CHO is there. This is the functional group. Okay, the adjacent carbon to functional group is called as alpha carbon. This hydrogen we called as alpha hydrogen. Here there is no adjacent carbon, so there is no alpha hydrogen and there is no alpha carbon. The aldehydes which not having the alpha hydrogen, those involves in Cannizzaro reaction in the presence of strong base. What happened? One undergoes oxidation, one undergoes reduction. Okay, for example, first undergoes reduction. Here add hydrogen. One hydrogen added 8 carbon, one hydrogen added 8 oxygen. What you will get? We'll get methyl alcohol. And here I am using potassium hydroxide also. Okay, this molecule converts into HCOOK. That means here oxygen will be added, here hydrogen will be added. That means first molecule undergoes reduction, second molecule undergoes oxidation. It undergoes reduction in the presence of that, it undergoes oxidation. Okay, if any molecule, one molecule undergoes oxidation and reduction, that reaction we called as disproportion reaction. This is the one important reaction, this is the one important disproportionation organic reaction. organic disproportionation reaction. Okay, here I am taking benzaldehyde. One mole benzaldehyde. This is another mole benzaldehyde. In the presence of sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. Concentrate sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. Okay, one molecule undergoes reduction. That means it converts into benzyl alcohol. Okay, it converts into sodium benzoate. Sodium benzoate. This is the sodium benzoate. This is benzyl alcohol. Okay, this is methyl alcohol. This is potassium formate. Okay, this is about the Kenny-Jevro reaction. In continuation, we'll see the aldol condensation, ketal condensation, cross-aldol condensation, cross-ketal condensation, and uses of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, after that, we'll see the carboxylic acid. Thank you.